So let's take a look at an example of making a shortcut using the Shortcuts app in iOS 12. So we're going to make a shortcut that takes a picture, but we're going to add a bunch of things to it. So let's go into the Shortcuts app here. If you don't have the Shortcuts app, go to the Mac App Store, search for Shortcuts. It's the app from Apple. And now you have the ability to build these scripts, kind of like Automator on Mac. And you can assign them, of course, to Siri. So you can actually ask Siri to do it. I showed you how to do that a couple weeks ago. We're just going to concentrate on actually building the script here. So I'm going to tap Create Shortcut here to create a new shortcut. Now the first thing we're going to do is we're going to search, because there's so many different actions that you can add. So you can look through them and definitely do browse through them. But to get to things quickly, we'll search. So we're going to look for camera shortcuts here. And there's a whole bunch of different ones. We'll use Take Photo and we'll drag that over here. And it gives you some options. You can show the preview of the shot. You can take a photo and how many photos you're going to take and which camera to use. We'll do the front camera. So let's look at what we've got so far. If I press play, it brings up me. I take the photo. I have the chance to retake at the bottom left or use photo. I'll hit use photo and it gives me the result there. Now that's far from being automated. So we're going to change some things. We're going to take away the preview. Let's hit play now. And it will automatically just take the picture. And there I am. So it just does it automatically. That's great. That's exactly what we want. Now, what would be really cool is if we could take several pictures, right? A little strip like you're in a photo booth or something like that. So we can actually do that. We can look for things, commands that repeat. So there's the repeat command. We'll bring repeat over, drag that over here. There we go. And you can see it has repeat and then an end repeat. So we're going to have to drag the photo one in between that and see how it puts it in between there. So repeat one time, take the photo, end repeat. Let's increase that to two times. Actually, let's do it three times. So what will happen now when I run it is it'll take three photos. So it took three photos and what we got was the last one. That's not really useful. What we want is all three of them, right? So there's a way to do that. Let's look for combine. And there is combine images. Let's add combine images here to the end. I'll drag that in. And you can see the lines that link these. There's a line that links the end repeat to combine images. So it's actually smart enough to realize that we are doing the same thing three times and take all three of those results and put them in here. And we'll do combined images, how we're going to do it. Side by side or grid. Let's do it side by side but vertically. Let's increase the spacing a bit. So there's a little bit of space between each one to 10. Now let's see what we get. There we go. It actually took three photos and combine them and we can see it in the result there. That's not that useful still because all we're doing is seeing the result here in Shortcuts. So let's go and see what we can do with them. One thing we can do is we can do a quick look and a quick look displays results. Now it does more than that as you'll see in a second here. Here is the result. So this is the result of the script. There's my quick look. Notice what quick look does on the upper right hand corner is share. And I have the ability to share that, which is exactly what I want. I want to be able to trigger this, have it take three shots, put them in a strip like this, a little bit of spacing between each one, and now I can share it if I like the results. Or hit done if I don't, and it just goes away. That's perfect. I could actually do more than that. Like for instance, I could look at photos here and I could see they're saved to photo album right here. I could drag that in and just have it automatically saved to photo album. I could also pick ones for say messages here. And I could have, you know, a send message with that. Send photo via WhatsApp. There's a whole bunch of stuff. There's Instagram links and all sorts of things. So you can actually have this end instead of quick look and using share, you can have it actually do something automatically. I like this thing ending in quick look. It's pretty versatile. We can actually do five versions here and you know, have it do a really cool strip. And there's my strip there. Now I can share it. So I like that. Now I'll go to settings here. I'll name it something. So we can name it like, you know, photo booth strip, like that. We could hit the Add to Siri button to actually give it a Siri command. So I can actually just hold my iPhone up. I'm doing this on an iPad, but I can do it on the iPhone. Hold the iPhone up. Say, take a photo strip or take a photo booth strip or whatever I want. I could add this to the home screen as a home screen button. So it's almost like its own app. Or I can just run it here as a widget. You know, when I hit done here, at the top right you can see photo booth strip is now there. So I can just go into shortcuts and launch it from there. So there's an example of a simple shortcut thing that uses a couple of different actions, including a very simple loop.